that the Congress is actually filing two separate pleas before the Chief Justice's bench or the office in the Supreme Court. What they are actually saying, there are two pleas. First plea is actually challenging, and demanding a stay on the oath-taking ceremony or the swearing-in ceremony of B.S. Yediyurappa. So this has to be heard before 9 a.m. tomorrow morning, because the scheduled oath-taking ceremony is around 9:30. The second plea is, which Mr. Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi has talked about, is the 15-day leeway that's been given. And I has said that in the past, the Supreme Court has crunched it to 48 hours. That should be the first. That should be priority. That can be heard sometime through the day tomorrow or perhaps on a later date. But the most urgent hearing is the one seeking stay on the oath-taking ceremony. Samia Kapoor joins us with the details. Yes, Samia.
Well, clearly the Congress party over here is categorically seeking one thing very strongly at this juncture, is that the oath-taking ceremony of the BJP's own candidate B.S. Yediyurappa, that is scheduled to take place tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. They are questioning the very legality of the governor inviting Yediyurappa to come and be sworn as the chief minister, where he has not been able to come forth and project the numbers of the majority to form the government. The BJP today stands at 104, which is not requisite to form the government in Karnataka. The Congress party wants a midnight intervention from the CJI. They want an urgent hearing from the CJI. We are waiting to hear from him, while the Congress party has already moved the Supreme Court. The petition has already been moved. If not tonight, until tomorrow morning, 9 a.m., the Congress party would want the CJI to hear the matter. While another plea that has also been filed with the Supreme Court is about 15 days' time being given by the governor to the to BJP to garner numbers, to come and showcase themselves, to be close to the halfway mark to form the government in Karnataka. But the Congress party is categorically saying that this is unconstitutional, where the governor gives a 15 days long time. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, who has been entrusted this crucial job by the Congress party, has also taken to Twitter, and where he is also indicating that it looks like the governor is encouraging horse trading.